Hi students, this is the part 3 video of the knee joint. Just we'll ask some questions whether you are able to answer this or not. Try yourself. And first is the capsule. Which side the capsule is deficit? So we have read the capsule covers the anterior, posterior, both the sides, and anteriorly it is supported by the quadriceps muscle, and posteriorly it is supported by the oblique popliteal ligament, and both sides it is supported by the lateral retinocular. Now my question is, which side it is deficit? Can you see it is going up by the anterior side, so below the quadriceps. So anteriorly, superiorly it is deficit, and it is communicated with the suprapetalar bursa. The bursa present above the petala is called the suprapetalar bursa. So it is deficit on the upper side. And it communicates with which bursa? It communicates with the suprapetalar bursa. This is petala. So above the petala it is called a suprapetalar bursa. Okay, very good. And then next question is, this is about the capsule, and it is strengthened on each side by the, I said, the retinocular. What is retinocular? It is the extension of the vastus lateralis, and lateral retinocular is from the vastus lateralis, and vastus the medial retinocular is from the vastus medialis, and posteriorly by the oblique popliteal ligament, which is the expansion of the semimembranous tendon. Understood? So this is about the capsule. Then this is about the ligaments, and the first ligament, what is lateral retinocular? Just now we said, what could be the answer? Yes, it is an extension of vastus lateralis. And what is medial retinocular? It's the extension from the vastus medialis muscle. These are the muscles of the anterior compartment of thigh. And the next is oblique popliteal ligament. What is oblique popliteal ligament? Just now I said oblique popliteal ligament can be seen posteriorly. Look at this. This is a posterior aspect, and here only your semimembranosus comes. This is the expanded part of the semimembranosus, number one, and it is an expansion of semimembranosus. Okay, and then it is pierced by, so it is in the middle. It is present in the knee joint. So middle knee joint. What is the other name for the knee joint? Genu. So the vessels are called as middle genicular vessels. Can anybody could recollect the nerve piercing that? Yes, this is a genicular again. Genicular nerve. Which genicular nerve? It is coming down. So descending genicular branch of posterior division of obturator nerve. This is the MCQ commonly asked. Which division of obturator nerve? It is the posterior division of obturator nerve, right? And then middle genicular vessels. Then tibial collateral ligament. Tibial collateral ligament, the point number one is it is a degenerated tendon of tibial, means medial side. Medial side, which muscle comes here? Adductor tubercle is here. So what muscle? Yes, adductor magnus. So adductor tubercle means adductor magnus. So degenerated tendon of adductor magnus. Second question is, this ligament is attached to, where it is attached to? The medial side, no? So medial condyle of femur to the medial condyle of tibia. It is going towards the tibia. Okay, and here only the medial condyle, only all these three muscles called gyrus, sartorius, gracilis, semitendinosus come and gets its insertion here. So it will all these muscles, they cross this area, tibial collateral ligament. And this ligament is attached to, it is attached to the, can you see this ligament is attached to which meniscus here? Medial meniscus and coronary ligament. Okay, so it is attached to the medial meniscus and coronary ligament. So it is very tight. So the look at the question, medial meniscus. So what is the complication you expect because of the attachment of the meniscus? So attached meniscus is attached to the tibial collateral ligament. So it is more prone for injury between the two condyles. It is more prone for injury because of the tight attachment with the tibial collateral ligament. So it restricts which movement? So it restricts the abduction. Again, don't say adduction, because it is on the medial side. So if you want to abduct too much, this cannot contract too much, so it will restrict the abduction. Okay, but if the ligament is torn, what will happen? If you abduct, then abnormal abduction will happen. And then lateral ligament or fibular collateral ligament, look at this. This is the lateral one. So from the lateral contact to the fibula, understood? And it is not attached with the lateral meniscus. Tibial collateral was attached to the medial meniscus, but it is not attached to the lateral meniscus, because in between you have a nice tendon comes here. What is this tendon? Tendon of popliteus. So this is the fibular collateral ligament. Inside that only you have the meniscus. In between these two there is a ligament called tendon of popliteus. Name the tendon lies below this ligament. What is the tendon? Tendon of popliteus. And then next is, name the muscle lying on it. On. So this, above that you will be having the biceps femoris and the lateral head of gastrocnemius will be coming from here, right? These two. And why medial meniscus is not prone for injury? Because of the in-between structure, that is your popliteal tendon. That's why it escapes, and few fibers of the popliteus, it gets inserted into the meniscus. So between, during the extension or unlocking moment, this nicely takes out the meniscus, because of the contraction of the popliteus, the few fibers of the popliteus gets inserted into the lateral meniscus. It nicely protects the lateral meniscus, restricts adduction. And this is the cruciate ligament, anterior cruciate ligament. Give its attachment, anybody? This is the anterior, right? What is this area? Intercondylar area. So anterior part of the intercondylar area goes to which condyle? It goes to the lateral condyle. So lateral condyle, which surface it is going? Medial surface. So it is going to the lateral condyle. A, anterior, lateral. So lateral condyle, medial surface. Taut in extension, when you extend your neck, complete extension, it is taut. And then next is the posterior cruciate ligament. So now we look at this, this is the posterior aspect. So posterior part of the intercondylar line, and it is going, that was going to the lateral condyle, so it should go to the medial condyle and the lateral surface of the medial condyle, right? And then next is, it is taut during flexion. And arcuate ligament, arcuate ligament, what is the shape of the arcuate ligament is the first question. What is the shape? Yeah, it is Y shape, and the stem of the Y is in the head of the, can you see this, fibula. The stem is in the head of the fibula. And then coronary ligament. Coronary ligament is nothing but the cap connective tissue between the meniscus and the capsule. Meniscus and the capsule. So you have two coronary ligaments. And meniscofemoral ligament. Meniscus to femur. Okay, that meniscofemoral ligament is here. Anterior meniscofemoral ligament and posterior meniscofemoral ligaments are there. Anterior meniscofemoral ligament, MCQ. It is called as ligament of Humphrey. H alphabet comes first. So ligament of Humphrey is anterior meniscofemoral ligament. Ligament posterior meniscofemoral ligament is called ligament of Risberg. Okay, Risberg. And ligaments of the knee joint, all the ligaments you can see. This is anterior aspect. Anterior aspect only you can see the here. Okay, ligamentum patellae, we have reflected here. Tibial tuberosity is here. And the ligamentum patellae is attached to the apex of the patella to the tibial tuberosity. Ligamentum patellae, it's very important. It is a continuation or degenerated part of quadriceps tendon. And ligamentum patellae is here one. And you have the anterior cruciate ligament. And behind you have the posterior cruciate ligament. Both the sides, lateral collateral, tibial collateral and fibular collateral ligaments are here. And then posteriorly you can see the posterior cruciate and the same ligaments. And then this is about the meniscus, and two meniscus you could see. And which meniscus is circular? Obviously the lateral meniscus, let's look at this. This is rounded in shape, okay, round in shape, medial meniscus. And the lateral meniscus is circular in shape, and shape of lateral meniscus is circular, almost it is round. And the medial meniscus is semilunar in shape. Look at this. This is wide, and this is almost like a circle, small one. And which meniscus is prone for injury? Obviously, medial meniscus, because it is attached with the tibial collateral ligament. Fibers of popliteus gets inserted into which meniscus? Obviously, lateral meniscus, because it arises from the lateral condyle of the popliteal groove in the lateral condyle of the femur. So it should go and gets its insertion towards the lateral meniscus. Locking, unlocking. Unlocking muscle is popliteus. How much degree unlock? It has to 30 degree unlock. During which moment? During flexion. When you flex your knee joint, when you extend your knee joint nicely, the lateral meniscus, look at this picture. When you extend, This lateral meniscus, lateral condyle is comes and slides nicely with the lateral meniscus of the knee joint. Meniscus is what? Nothing but the fibrocartilaginous structure. That is more important. It is made up of fibrocartilaginous structure, and periphery is thick, central is thin, and it is intracapsular, extrasynovial, and the peripheral part has nerve supply. The central part doesn't have avascular. And next is the lateral condyle is small, lateral meniscus is also circular, so it is nicely fixed into it. But medial meniscus is a bit larger, and medial condyle is also larger, so it cannot fix up easily. So what happened, it has to make another 30 degree medial rotation of this medial condyle of femur on the tibia. This is called as locking of the knee joint. The same thing when you extend your when you want to flex, that time it has to come out 30 degrees, then only it can come out and proceed the movement of the flexion. So 30 degrees flexion, it is called unlocking. Medial condyle of femur is working on the tibia. So medial rotation and lateral rotation. Medial rotation is called locking, lateral rotation is called unlocking. Unlocking muscle is called popliteus. Bursa, you have few bursa. You have the this is patella, above the patella suprapatellar bursa, in front prepatellar bursa, and this is the ligamentum patellae. Above that you have the subcutaneous infrapatellar bursa, behind that deep infrapatellar bursa, and these are all other important bursa. You just go and have, this is only more important. And the housemate's knee is housemate prepers. Keep it in mind, prepare. So prepatellar bursitis is called housemate's knee, and clergyman's knee, yes, subcutaneous infrapatellar bursa, because of the kneel down posture they have the bursitis here in the subcutaneous infrapatellar bursa. Which bursa communicates with the knee joint? Suprapatellar bursa is the answer. This is called genu varum, not knee, genu valgum. Thank you.